Hey crafters, welcome back to my channel Because I'm Crafty. My name's Katelyn and today I'm going to talk to you about my top 10 drafting tools. So whether you use store-bought patterns or you make your own patterns or want to copy your own clothes, these are some tools that I think are must-have when pattern drafting. So none of these items are in a order of importance, they're just all important to me, so let's get into it. So some of the tools you need for pattern drafting, if you're self-drafting, you need some writing utensils. So to draw your actual patterns out, when I was in school for fashion design, we used some lead-filled pencils that you buy like the refills for, and you just click it and the lead comes out. These are the Staedtler Mars Micro. And we used these 0.5mm 2H refills. This is what we were required to use in school, and I don't know, I don't have an issue with it. I really liked using these. I like that they're refillable because I didn't always have to like sharpen an actual pencil, whereas this I could just click it and have more lead or put a new refill in, which was great. The other thing you need for your drawing utensils is an eraser, of course, in case you mess up. Make sure you get an actual good eraser because you don't want to be sitting there struggling trying to erase your lines if you need to, and then, you know, end up ripping your paper and having to start over, which is really annoying. And the other writing utensil that I suggest you have are some different color pens or pencils. I like to mark my dart points with, you know, a color, and mark my seam allowance with another, make things kind of color coded. I really liked using this when we're required to do our quarter scales in class. It kind of made things easier to understand and make things stand out if we needed to, especially if you want to mark your notches with a certain color, because when everything's all kind of on white paper with your pencil, everything kind of just gets blended in together and it's hard to pinpoint things. So if you mark your notches with one color, mark your drill points and your dart points with another, then everything stands out and you can clearly see everything that you need to mark on your fabric before you start sewing. Another tool you need for pattern drafting, and if you're using store-bought patterns, is to have a separate pair of paper scissors. I can't stress this enough. If you don't keep your paper scissors separate from your fabric scissors and you go to cut your paper with your fabric scissors, they're gonna get dull like right away. So definitely keep a separate pair of scissors, get a different color, label them, do whatever you need to do, but keep the paper separate from the fabric and your fabric separate from your paper. Next thing you need to mark your patterns are some tracing wheels. So another tool that goes along with this is some transfer paper, but I'll talk about that in a minute. But these tracing wheels you can use to mark your darts if you want to on your fabric. So you can take your transfer paper, or sometimes it's called dressmaker's tracing paper, and you can lay that underneath your fabric and use this tracing wheel and follow the line that you've drawn on your pattern for your dart. And this tracing paper has like a layer of wax on it, and so when you run it over with your tracing wheel, it'll leave little dots that follow the line that you've traced, and then you can see where you need to sew your dart or your notches or whatever you want to mark with it. Another thing too, if you're trying to match different sides of your patterns and get things equal, you can use this to trace over on your pattern paper to true out your sides, so you kind of get an indentation in your paper, and then you can follow that along with your pencil afterwards. There are two types of tracing wheels. This one has like little grooves on it. It's not too sharp, like I can touch it with my finger and be fine. This is more so used for going over fabric with the transfer paper, but there's ones that have like really sharp spikes on them, and that's for going through paper because it's easier to see the holes that are through the paper than these like tiny indentations that these wheels make. So there are two different kinds. I usually stick with these ones because I can usually see it okay on the paper, but there are the sharp ones as well that are specifically made for paper. And to talk a little bit more about the dressmaker's tracing paper, so they usually come in a little packet like this. This is really old. It says 65 cents on it. I think my mom's had it in her kind of sewing kit for a long time. but they usually come with a few different sheets with different colors in it. So this one's like a navy color. And this one's purple. There's usually a white one as well, and sometimes red. But you'll put this face up towards the side of fabric that you want to be drawing on. So usually you do it on your wrong side of your fabric, and then you'll have your tracing paper, your fabric with the wrong side facing towards your wax side, and then your pattern will be on top, and then you'll use your tracing wheel to put pressure on it. And with the pressure, it'll transfer the wax onto your fabric, and then you have your markings on your fabric for where you need to sew or whatever you need to mark. So this original paper came with 2 sheets of white, 2 sheets of blue, 1 sheet of red, 1 sheet of yellow, and 1 sheet of orange. So I haven't looked for this lately because my mom's had one, but it's really great tool to have if you want to transfer your markings on your pattern onto your fabric. Another thing when pattern making to marking your darts or your drill holes or anything like that is to have an awl. Now an awl you can use for your paper or for your fabric as well. When I was marking my drill points and darts in school, I would normally still have my pattern pinned to my fabric, and then I would just take the awl and punch it through. So basically it's a very sharp ended stick with a point at the end, and basically it's used to punch through your fabric and it makes a hole. It pretty much pushes the fibers out of the way. It doesn't normally actually break the fibers and put a hole in your fabric. It just kind of pushes them out of the way. And then you can use that to mark your darts and sew your fabric and all of that. So definitely another tool to have when pattern making. So a very important tool for measuring is a measuring tape. You can get a measuring tape that it's 60 inches long, and the other one they normally sell is 120 inches long. So I have a 120, incredibly useful for measuring your patterns, measuring around a person, just measuring everything you need for pattern making and sewing. So definitely a must have in your kit. Another thing to have for pattern making is a notcher. Now I don't have a notcher, but I'll insert a photo of one here. They're quite expensive, so I haven't invested in one yet. And when I was in school for fashion design, there were ones made available for us to use for our patterns, so I didn't end up purchasing one when I was in school. But it's just a little punch, and you take it and you can mark your notches. Definitely easier so that since it punches the fabric out from where your notch is supposed to be, when you go to cut out your fabric, you could just cut inside that hole where the notch is, and you don't have to cut into your paper with your fabric scissors. So it's definitely a good tool to have. So another tool to have for pattern making is your tracing paper. If you're going to make your own patterns, you need something to draw them on. So I found this tracing paper at school. I used to buy it in the bookstore. Before I graduated, I bought a couple rolls of it, so I still have some left. But I will link some places down below on Amazon if I can find some really good tracing paper. But I haven't had to order any since, so I haven't tried any of those. But if I find some, I will link some down below. If you know of a great place to buy tracing paper or the hard cardboard paper, some people prefer that as well. I like to use that just for my blocks or my base patterns, and then I like to use those on the tracing paper to create new patterns. But if you have a great resource to buy those, make sure to leave it down in the comments so we can all use it. So the last thing I'm going to talk about is 3 different rulers that I think are really important to have for pattern making. And the first one is a see-through ruler. This is an 18-inch ruler, and so half of it is marked with inches in little like cubes here, and the other side has centimeters running down the side. Now I really like this one because each eighth of an inch is marked off inside the inch square, and then along the edge of the ruler even the 16th of an inch are marked on here. So I really like to use this for marking my seam allowance. I use this every day in class. I've bought a couple of these. I've lost a couple of these. I think I have 2 or 3 of them at the moment on hand because they're just amazing for pattern making. And since they're all kind of cubed off, it's really good for marking your seam allowances when you're pattern drafting because you can clearly see everything. It's got every eighth marked. Everything that you need is on this ruler. So definitely, if you're gonna buy a ruler, buy this one first. and they're not expensive at all, and I'll link those down below as well. And the second ruler that I 100% recommend having is some kind of curved ruler. This one is called the Grading Ruler and Seam Allowance Guide Curve for Neckline, Armhole, Sleeve Cap, Hemline, and Waistline. It's the Imperial French Curve, so it's got the inches on here. It's got a similar see-through ruler kind of guide along this flat side. It goes up to 16 inches. It's got every eighth matched off as well, just like the see-through ruler. But I find with this curve kind of being in the way, it was harder to use for marking my seam allowances and drawing in class, so I definitely used the other one for that. It's great like for this curve, like as I said, for necklines, armholes, sleeve caps, hemlines, and waistlines. This is a great French curve. I really like this one because it's see-through. There's some out there that are metal that I really like the curve that they have as well, but it's hard to see where you are on your pattern because you can't see through the ruler because it's metal. So I like that this is see-through. I can see exactly where I'm drawing in comparison to everything else that I've already drawn. So I really like that aspect. And along the outside of the ruler, it's measured as well. So it's measured in inches. And so going around the curve, we've got 30 inches. And then it's also got marked off some seam allowance guides. So it's got 5/8, 1/2 inch, and 1/4 inch. So after you draw your curve, you can follow that same curve and draw your seam allowance with the same ruler. So this is definitely a great one. And my last one that I have for pattern making, which I also love to use this with my rotary cutter when I cut out my fabrics, this is the OmniGrip 24-inch by 6-inch ruler. I will link it down below as well. I know it's on Amazon for sure. But I really like to use this. Everything's marked off. Same thing, we've got the cubed inches. We've got all the 1/4 inches and 8 inches marked off. I use this ruler a lot for cutting out my fabric. It's really quite thick, and I like that because it's easier to use with my rotary cutter because it's got a nice thick base to kind of rub up against when I do use the ruler, especially if I'm cutting out something straight or cutting out strips. It's nice and long, it's a perfect width. And it also has down on this one end, you probably won't be able to see it from there with the glare, but down here there's some diagonal lines on here. So it's marking off some degrees. So we've got a 30 degree, a 45, and a 60, and then the same going the opposite way. So depending on which way you need to put your ruler, you've got it from both sides. And this is really great if you need to cut bias tape or something like that. You need a 45 degree angle on your fabric. It's marked on this ruler, so you can use the straight edge on the kind of selvage edge of your fabric, and then you can use that 45 degree angle to get the cut that you need. So this is definitely a really great ruler to have as well. So those are my top 10 pattern drafting tools. If you have any favorites, let me know down in the comments below. And if you have any video requests, let me know as well. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and subscribe so you don't miss out on any future videos. And I'll see you next time, crafters. Bye!